Hello friends, welcome to our channel Castor Classes. And in this particular video, I am going to discuss how we can read, write or append some new lines in a file, text file in Python, okay? In Jupyter Notebook, I will be showing. So for that, first of all, we are going to read the file. So first, let me open one file which is already created in desktop and the file name is check. And I have written three lines in it. First line is, this is to check whether file reading is done or not. Second line is hello world. Third line is hello Python. Now I want to read this file. How to read this file? Very simple. You just give one variable name which will store that and then write open. Okay. Then give parenthesis. Inside parenthesis, give the address of the file. Okay. Like here, if you go to properties of the file, you will be getting the complete address. I am just copying the complete address and pasting here inside single quotation as a string. Okay. And then give the file name, that is check.txt, that is text file. And wherever this slash is appearing, single slash, make that double slash. Okay. Don't forget to do that. Otherwise, you will be getting error. All right. So now if I run, now we can read the file using this e variable. Okay, e dot read. Okay, if I am writing e dot read 4, if I run, I will be getting this. What it is reading actually? It is actually reading the first four characters of our file. This, okay, THIS, four characters, right? Then again you write the same code. Okay, now I am writing e dot read 4. Okay, you know what you will be getting as output? See, understand it very carefully. Already first four characters we have read. So next four characters it will read and it will give in the output. So first character will be space, then I, then S, then one more space. So these are four characters, right? So we should get that. Let us check. If I run, I will be getting this one. See, first space, then I, S, is, and then one more space. Again, if I write e dot read 4, now what will happen? Again, next four characters it will read, like T, O, one space and C. Okay, if you write 5, e dot read 5, it will read up to H. Okay, so if you write e dot 5, you will be getting T, O, then space, then C, then H. Let us check. If I write instead of 4, if I write 5, I'll be getting T, O, then space, then C, then H. Alright, this is how reading is done. So basically, what it does, there is one kind of cursor which will be in that position up to where reading is done. From that position, it will read next characters. Okay, like here, we have already read up to CH, so the cursor is now at this position. Now it will start reading further as many characters it will give. Suppose you are not giving anything in the read. Okay, you just simply write now e dot read and parenthesis open, parenthesis closed. That is, you have not written anything. Now what is our, where is our cursor? Our cursor is here, right? So what it will do, it will read the whole file. Okay, and see, after not, hello world and hello Python are respectively in new lines. These new lines will be printed as backslash n, which basically indicates new line in Python, right? Let us check. If I run, see, starting from eck, see, check, here our cursor was there, so started from eck, then whether file reading is done or not, then hello world, hello Python. See how it is reading? Eck, whether file reading is done or not, backslash n, this indicates going to new line, then hello world, then again backslash n, that is hello Python. Okay, so this is how file reading is done in Python. Now suppose you apply one more time e dot read. Okay, see, after applying this e dot read, our complete file reading is done, right? So our basically cursor is at the end. Now if you read once more, you will not be getting anything because your file reading is completed. No more characters are there after this n. So you will be getting empty, that is empty character. Okay, so that is single quotation open, then single quotation closed, empty string you will be getting. All right, now suppose you want to go back to the beginning of the file. That is, you want to make your cursor again to the beginning. You need to write E dot S double E K seek 0. Okay, you have to write this. All right, now you can check. Again, I am applying E dot read suppose 3. So what will happen? E dot seek will take the cursor, which was at the end actually in our code. It will take again to the beginning, and then after reading E, after executing E dot read 3, it will read basically first 3 characters. Okay, if I run E dot read 3, I'll be getting THI, because first 3 characters of this is THI. Okay, this is how file reading is done. Now, while reading a file, you want to know where your actual cursor is present now. Like here, our actual cursor is, we have read up to this THI, so our actual cursor is blinking here, right? After I and before S. Okay, so what you can do to get the cursor index, you can simply write E dot tell. All right, and then bracket open, bracket close. There is parenthesis open, parenthesis close. If you run, you'll be getting 3. Okay, so 0, 1, 2. So it is blinking at the third index position. Okay, because first character, second character, third character, up to second index, it is reading is done. So from the third character, it will start reading and it will go on. Okay, right. And then after reading is done, you must write this one, E dot close. Whatever inside or in the back end you have opened to read the file, everything should be closed. Okay, if you simply write E, you will be getting IO text, IO wrapper name, C user Satyendra Mukherjee desktop check text mode R encoding pattern. And see, mode equal to R is basically indicating that we are reading the file. Similarly, writing is also possible, and appending some new lines in a file also possible. That I will be discussing in my next video. Thank you for watching.